Good evening, friends. Thank you for taking time out today to attend this webinar. I know how precious this time is, as each one of us is trying to try out new things in our own unique manner. I hope this webinar is able to do justice to your time investment. This lockdown, I believe, is a blessing in disguise for two reasons. One, probably we wouldn't have come up with the idea of this webinar and would have gone the traditional route of foot on ground sales to have made sure that the message reaches to you. The other blessing is for the Indian economy as a whole, which I believe is relatively more resilient and will recover faster than its developed counterparts, and thus benefit from the shifting of manufacturing base from the other countries. Hence, even though real estate might be up for a couple of difficult quarters, I believe in the longer run, it would not much deviate from its target of $1 trillion economy by 2030. I personally am very optimistic about life after the COVID. And the more important challenge that will lie before all of us construction professionals is of taming the elephant that the construction industry is. Contributing close to 8% of nation's GDP and close to 7% of the nation's workforce, India's construction industry is second largest, next only to China. It is, however, plagued by poor productivity. In fact, construction productivity growth has lagged behind manufacturing productivity growth by almost half. This is very well reflected in the completion of PMAY Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana housing units, which lags behind its target of 2 crore homes by 2024. Close to only 30 lakh homes have been built so far. Even the government knows this well and thus launched a global housing technology challenge last year, wherein they invited close to 150 construction technology companies from across the world to find faster ways of building these homes. It is with this need and opportunity in mind that we started MagicReap way back in 2008. Since then, we have been on a mission to help people build their homes better, faster, and cheaper. Over the years, our flagship product, AAC Blocks, has transformed the way walls are built in the country, leading to faster and greener construction. We are proud to have supplied more than 200 million blocks to over 2,000 projects, which have helped build close to 2 lakh homes. We knew we couldn't stop there. We knew to move further up the industrialization scale, we had to rethink the entire construction process. We had to move construction from on-site to the factory and follow an assembly line approach, like how it's being done in the automobile manufacturing industry. In a way, making homes more like how cars are made. Our R&D team did lots of iterations with various technologies, and this led to birth of what we call third generation construction technologies, MagicPod and MagicLight. This is the topic of today, and these are the technologies that bring all of us here together. I would like to proudly point out here that MagicReap is one of the winners of Global Housing Technology Challenge because of our MagicPod technology. And you all are going to get to know of this technology more about today. I'll now open the space for our esteemed speakers who have joined us today from Germany, Singapore, and Netherlands, and also our in-house team who are going to share their knowledge with us. Thank you once again for joining us.
Of course, mission has been beautifully explained by Saurabh sir. I'll not put much time on it, but just a snapshot of our growth story. We started in 2008 and our first plant was commercialized in 2009 in Surat, followed by another plant in 2013 in Jhajjar, Haryana for catering north market. Eventually, other business verticals like dry mix products and precast were followed. Also, Motilal Oswal is one of the investors in our company. We are proud to say that we are one of the only companies in AAC industry who have been funded by private equity. These are some of the awards which we have got in last few years, which motivate us to achieve our mission. Magic Rate, I would say, is one of the formal companies in this highly unorganized sector, which has world-class infrastructure and which is very much technology-driven. Now, coming to the main core question, why AAC? I would say we are all aware of the negative impacts, negative environmental impacts that Red Bricks has, be it right from raw materials to the process or even after installation. For an example, the same amount of blocks that we manufacture for bricks, we would require 40 times more land and 10 times more labor. Also, the energy consumption is pretty high as far as Red Bricks is concerned. Also, I've seen a lot of questions about ECBC, ECBC Plus asked by guests. So I would definitely say that AAC currently is one of the best green building materials that is available as far as walling material is concerned, considering the U value that it has. It can reduce your HVAC load. Also, the embodied energy is very low as far as AAC products is concerned. India has great huge scope for AAC products. It merely started with 50 crore market, and right now we are touching close to 4,000 crore market. Also, the market share, which is close to 8-10% right now, is bound to grow up to 40% by 2030. So there's huge scope of AAC products that India would see. Indian real estate, as mentioned by Saurabh sir, we are currently short of 2 crore homes. Also, with rapid urbanization and schemes like Housing for All, Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, we definitely need innovations which are sustainable, cost-friendly, and help faster construction. So I would proudly present to you what we think would be the next big shift in wall construction. And it is a technology shift from bricks to blocks to panels. So AAC, Magic Light AAC wall panels are definitely here to stay. There's a short video regarding the same. I would like to play it and then we can discuss it in detail.
More than a decade ago, Magic Reed set out to help people build their homes better, faster and cheaper with its flagship autoclaved aerated concrete blocks. AAC blocks are lightweight, allow faster construction and offer exceptional thermal insulation, fire rating and acoustic properties. Continuing on its journey of innovation, Magic Reed once again brings the next big shift in construction technology with Magic Light AAC wall panels. These full-height wall panels have all the magical features of AAC and more. Being as lightweight as AAC makes them easy to handle and install, making construction 4 times faster than AAC blocks. Corrosion-protected steel reinforcement makes them durable and crack-free. Now do away with coping and plastering on the walls to save time and cost. Manufactured in fully automated factory, Magic Light panels adhere to IS6072 quality standards, made in a single or double-layered steel mesh with tongue and groove. The panels can meet challenging design requirements. Its 4-hour fire rating enables thinner wall sections, saving space and delivering higher carpet area. The installation process is non-complicated. Can be executed by semi-skilled labor. MEP installations are fairly easy as panels can be chased easily. Be it residential, commercial, hotels or industrial projects, AAC wall panel technology has seen success globally. With Magic Light panels, you can trust the walling experts to bring to you the most robust walling solution of modern times. For a quick design and quote for your project, get in touch with a Magic Reed representative.
I think that was a great self-explanatory video. So basically, this corrosion protected steel reinforcement wall panels can be used for both external and internal non-load bearing walls. It provides 4 times faster construction. There is no requirement of coping. There is no requirement of plaster, as you have seen in video. The reinforcement also helps in providing flexural strength to the panels. It also avoids any kind of buckling effect that could create. Also, the tongue and groove helps in proper alignment. This panels comes in various sizes, as you can see on the screen, right from 75 mm to up to 200 mm. These panels are available with different heights. The AAC wall panels comply with IS 6072 Class D standards. And the properties, as you can see, are very, very much similar to AAC blocks. So I think there was one question asked. I'll just put one point on it, that do we have, for example, with ECBC, ECBC Plus coming up, do we have an option of AAC blocks? I would say yes, definitely this is an option which you can definitely think of. Also, if we compare the technologies, prevalent technologies that are available in the market now, right now, all the technologies have some of the cons associated with it. For example, hollow core or solid pica definitely help in the construction. But because city and the weight increase the load on the project, on the structure. Also, EPS sandwich panels, they are faster in construction. But because of double substrate, 2 kinds of substrate that they have, it might cause debonding in future. Also, the drywalls, it definitely has a knocking sound, which is the biggest limitation for its use, mainly in residential and some kind of projects. So if you see the various technologies, AAC panels stand apart. They are definitely the future that India would move towards to. Also, the biggest plus point is, if you see weight to strength ratio, that is something which is highest in AAC wall panels. So now, up till now, of course, you are aware of the key features that AAC wall panel has, be it lightweight, fire resistance, eco-friendly, thermal insulation, acoustic, space saving, time saving. And yes, they are cost friendly too. If you compare no coping, no plaster, reduce of manpower, definitely it gives an edge over other existing products in the market. As you have seen in the video, the installation process is pretty simple. These are the few basic tools that are used for installation, and installation process can be easily executed by semi-skilled laborers. A team of 3 to 4 laborers can easily execute around 400 square feet of wall in a day. And that is a huge, huge jump as compared to current AAC blocks manpower or current bricks manpower. These are the few steps of construction. I'll not go it in detail. I'll share this presentation afterwards with all the attendees. So basically, you install Becker rod, you install PU foam. So these are the few commonly available accessories that are used for this installation. Lintel installation is very simple. There's no need to do RCC lintel or procure precast lintel. This panel's being reinforced can be directly used as lintels. So there's just install the lintel, L-clamps can be fixed, and you are ready to go. Also, door and window installation is very similar to AC blocks. By hold fast method or anchoring system, you can easily do it. MEP installations are pretty simple. Chasing is easily possible, as similar to any AC product. Also, there's one more plus point. For example, if you have 100 mm wall and if you chase 75 mm of wall also, then there is no need of panic as far as structural stability is concerned. You are, be rest assured, the strength would be same. So these are some of the projects which have been where the panel have been used globally. So currently in global market, if I compare, around 68% market share is of AAC products, while for panels it is close to 30%, and that is increasing day by day. Of course, regarding more global experience, we have an expert from Netherlands, from Aircrete Europe, who would talk about it in detail. But this is definitely a way forward. and it's high time that India should adopt this technology now. I think that's it from my side. I am open for any questions. You can post it in Q&A section. I'll be happy to take at least 2-3 questions, if not more. And definitely all the questions would be answered offline through email. Thank you. Responded to few. And those who have been not been responded will definitely respond it offline. I'll take a couple of questions that I thought that many of people have asked. Right. Meanwhile, I'll share the screen once again. I'll put the cost matrix that people have asked for. I think that slide was a bit fast, I suppose. So I'll put that one again, and meanwhile, I'll answer the questions. Is it visible?
Yes, it is visible.
Okay. Yeah. So the first question was regarding load capacity. Whether people would be able to install kitchen units or stone cladding or such questions were there. So definitely if you use proper AAC fasteners, with single fastener, you can hold up to 50 kg, 60 kg of weight. So with four fasteners, you can hang a unit of say 200 to 20 kg also. So that would not be a problem with AAC wall panels. Similar to AAC blocks can hold, definitely the material is same. In fact, this is reinforced, so this would hold it much better. Moving on to second question that was there regarding height. What in case of higher heights, say more than 5 meters, 6 meters, 7 meters, right? So I think for 100 mm panel, the best solution would be there are two options. Either we can do 3 meters, one panel, then do coping in between, and then one more panel of 3 meters. Or another option is staggering arrangement. Right? So basically, there would be one small panel above that. There would be a bigger, a larger section of the panel. Then on the next slide, it would be the larger section first and the smaller section. Biju, you can let me know. I will just change the slide. Hello.
Put the slideshow mode on.
Okay. Okay. And the third common question I found was regarding MEP installations. So as mentioned, MEP installation are easy. You can easily chase it, even though reinforced. So there would be 40 mm capping for over the wall panels, after which reinforcement would start. But again, you can easily cut reinforcement. It is 6 mm reinforcement, so there won't be any problem. So I think somebody asked for 100 mm panel, if there is say 75 mm DB junction box or something like that, you can easily cut it. Even though it is 75 mm panel, you can cut the entire panel. You can, for example, a square in between for DB junction box, and there won't be problem as far as overall structural stability of that wall is concerned.